हेलो एवरीवन, आई रचना एच कलपनवर, लेक्चर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिपार्टमेंट इन जैन पॉलिटेक्निक बेलगामी। फॉर मोर वीडियोस सब्सक्राइब माय यूट्यूब चैनल आर्किटेक्ट यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द यूनिट 3 ऑफ अ मेजरमेंट इलेक्ट्रिकल मेजरमेंट एंड मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स सब्जेक्ट विच इज कवर्ड इन द डिप्लोमा सिलेबस, दैट इज कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड ऑपरेशन ऑफ वाट मीटर एंड एनर्जी मीटर। वॉट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडेज video means electrodynamometer type watt meter, construction and working, advantages and disadvantages, errors in the watt meter, next induction type single phase energy meter, construction and working, errors in energy meter. Watt meter is a device which is used to measure the power. So you can see this is our watt meter. Next, what is the power first? Power is the rate at which energy is consumed. Its unit is watt. If you consider the DC circuit, there only power is equal to V into I. If you consider single phase AC circuit, P is equal to VI cos phi. For three phase AC circuit, it will be root 3 VI cos phi. So you can see this watt meter connection diagram. Here it is a current coil and next is a pressure coil. Current coil is connected in the series with the load and pressure coil is in connected in parallel or across the supply. Always current coil is in series and pressure coil is in the parallel or across the supply. Current coil consists of the very less number of or few number of thick turns of wire connected in the series with the load, and pressure coil or potential coil consists of the large number of thin wires connected across the supply. This the watt meter reading directly gives the power consumed by the load. So first one, electrodynamometer type watt meter. It consists of two fixed coils, one moving coil, and these two fixed coils are connected in series with the load and moving coil is connected in parallel with the supply. Here is pointer and this is your scale, and one resistance is connected in series with your moving coil. So first we'll discuss about the construction. Electrodynamometer type watt meter consists of fixed coil and moving coil. Fixed coil is split up into two equal parts and placed at a distance and placed at a parallel with each other. See, this is a fixed coils connected in the series. These are placed at a distance, some distance, and always remember fixed coil is the current coil and it is connected in the series with the load and carries the current I1. Next come to the moving coil. Moving coil is in place in between the two fixed coils and it is connected across the supply and carries the current I2. Here resistance R is connected in series with that to limit the current, and it consists of the pointer which is connected to on the spindle of your moving coil and the springs controlling action, and this is the scale. This is about the construction. And next come to the working. See, it is also almost all on the motor working principle only. Whenever a current carrying coil is placed in the magnetic field, it is the force is exerted on that. Means here, what is a, when current carrying moving coil is placed in the magnetic field produced by the another carrying current coil is fixed coil. These two are fixed coils. It is also produced current carrying and here also current carrying. So when current carrying moving coil is placed in the magnetic field produced by another current carrying fixed coil, the force is exerted on the coil sides of this moving coil, due to which the deflection torque is produced and the moving coil deflects. When moving coil deflects, the pointer attached to this spindle moves over the graduated scale and comes to the rest point at a point when deflecting torque and the controlling torque will become equal. So that controlling action is done by whom? That controlling action is done by this springs. So this is our working of, this is the working of electrodynamometer type watt meter. That is only I given some points on the construction and the working. So what are the advantages and disadvantages? Means advantages, it can be used for the measurement of AC as well as DC power. Next, it is having a uniform scale. Scale is uniform, but in the some other instrument scale is will be not uniform. The readings will be cramped in some it is not at a same distance scale, so that is non-uniform scale, but here it is a uniform scale, and here accurate and the reliable give the proper readings. Next come to the disadvantages. The low power factors, inductance of the potential coil causes serious errors, because inductance also will be having, potential coil also will be having the some inductance, no, that lagging load is nothing but what, inductance action will be there. So coil is also having inductance, due to that in at low power factor the serious error will be occurring, and the reading of meter is affected by stray magnetic field. Stray magnetic field means beside any other magnetic field is there any other static electrostatic field is there, means that field is influence, it is affecting on that meter, then the reading of that also will be changes. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of electrodynamometer type wattmeter. Next we'll discuss some errors in the dynamometer type wattmeter. First is error due to pressure coil inductance. See, pressure coil inductance means it is coil is having the inductance, due to that some lagging of the current by the applied voltage, due to that also error will be occurring. If it is capacitance is there, means it will be leading. So only error due to pressure coil and capacitance is nothing but due to the capacitance, what happened, current will be leading the apply voltage, due to that also the error in the instrument. Next, eddy current. Eddy currents are introduced where the metallic parts are there, and there will be eddy currents will be there, due to that interaction and to the instrument current, then also there will be error in the reading. Stray magnetic field error is nothing but beside of our instrument, beside the instrument any other magnetic field or any other static electro field or any field is there, means that is influence, that affecting to the our device. So that time also it will be deflection, it will be affecting, no, magnetic field is affecting, means because the magnetic field of our meter is weak, that time it is affecting. So that time also it will show the some wrong readings. So to avoid that, actually shielding and all will be using. Next, temperature errors are nothing but, see, whenever the current is flowing, one main effect is what, heating effect. Heat will be produced. If heat is there, obviously it is affecting to our resistance. If the resistance is changing, is nothing but some value, the reading of that instrument values will be changing. Due to that, what will they will be doing to avoid that errors? Low coefficient materials, low coefficient temperature coefficient materials, manganese and all such materials they will be using in the instruments. Due to the sometimes frequency errors. Frequency errors are nothing but what, if just suddenly exactly 50 hertz will be not there, sometime it will be variation 49 point something or 51 point something, like that variation in the frequency. Due to that variation in the frequency, self inductance of the coil will be changes, due to that some errors in the reading. So this is about our electrodynamometer type wattmeter construction, advantages, disadvantages and the errors. Next, very important is induction type single phase energy meter. I think all of you seen this one in your home. See, this is aluminium disc. Nowadays it is replacing by digital meter, but still in some home we are using the induction type single phase energy meter. Why it is used? It is used to measure the energy. Always remember, energy unit is kilowatt hour. Electrical energy unit is we are using in the kilowatt hour. So this is our construction. So as you can see this, how it is the construction of the induction type single phase energy meter. Just see the diagram. It is a M type shape, it is there. This is called as the pressure coil, and here it is a U type, rectangular U type, it is called as the current coil, and here aluminium disc, and this is our breaking magnet, recording mechanism. So it is divided into four parts. One is the driving system, next is the moving system, next is the breaking system, and next is the recording mechanism. Like this, it is divided into four parts. The basic principle of induction type energy meter is electromagnetic induction. What is the working principle here, means when the alternating current flow through two suitable located coils. If two coils are there, I told you, know, here pressure coil and here the current coil. If this produces, because of these two suitably located coils, there will be production of the rotating magnetic field. If that rotating magnetic field is cut by this aluminium disc, what happens? EMF will be induced in the disc, and because of that EMF, eddy current will start to flow on that disc. Due to the interaction of that eddy current and the rotating magnetic field, the driving torque is produced and it starts to rotate. This is our basic working principle of the induction type single phase energy meter. First, one by one, we'll discuss about the construction. I told that it consists of diving, moving, braking and the recording system. First, let us come to the driving system. Driving system consists of the two magnets called a shunt magnet and the series magnet. So, shunt magnet and series magnet. Series magnet consists of the, it is a U-shaped lamination core, rectangular U-shape. That is nothing but we can call it as a current coil. The thick wire of few number of turns is wounded on the side limbs of this magnet, U-shaped magnet, and it is connected in series with the load. So, this is called as the current coil, first one. Next is the shunt magnet. Shunt magnet consists of the M-shaped core, and here it is M-shaped lamination core. Here, more number of or large number of wires, thin wires connected where it is wounded, it is on the central limb of the shunt magnet. It is called as the pressure coil or potential coil, and it is always connected across the supply. So this is the two. First one is which system? First one is the driving system. It consists of the two magnets, series magnet and the shunt magnet. Series magnet, the magnet shape is of rectangular U, and the few number of thick wire, copper wire, is wounded on the side limb of the rectangular U shaped coil magnet, and it is connected across the load. And the shunt magnet, it is a M shaped laminations, consist of core is consist of the M shaped laminations. Thin wires of copper wire is wounded on the central limb of that M shape, and is connected across the supply. So this is the first system. One thing you can see here, copper shading band. Why it is used, this copper shading band, means the main important condition in the driving system is what? The potential coil current should compulsory lag behind the apply voltage by 90 degree. The current in the potential coil must lag behind the apply voltage by 90 degree. To achieve this condition, copper shading band is provided in the central limb. This is very, very important condition. The current in the potential coil here, this current should compulsory lag behind this applied voltage by 90 degree. Then only the disc will start to rotate. So, only to achieve that condition properly, we are using the copper shading band. Next, come to the moving system. See, in this energy meter, the moving system is our disc, light aluminium disc. It is mounted on vertical spindle. You can call it as a shaft. Where it is placed? It is placed in the gap between series and the shunt magnet. Here it is, in the between the shunt and the series magnet, we are placing this aluminium disc. How much is the revolution, depending on the energy consumed by the load, is decided. This is the second system, moving system. Next, third is the braking system. Braking system consists of one permanent magnet known as the braking magnet. This one is placed near this edge of the aluminium disc. This magnet is used to control the speed of the disc. To control that, if it is this magnet is not there, then disc will be continuously rotating very fastly. To controlling action, we are using here the braking magnet. Next, come to the recording mechanism. The front panel dials and all will be there. It will be showing the readings. So, the function of the recording mechanism is to record a continuously number on the dial, which is proportional to the revolutions made by the moving system. That is, the number of revolution on the disc is measured by the electrical energy passing through the meter. How much is the revolution? Depending on that, only our electrical energy, how much is consumed, it will be measured, and it is connected to the recording mechanism. So this is about the construction of the induction type single phase energy meter. Next, we will see the working of the energy meter. See, some construction points I have given, just you people glance it once so that you can understand more better. So working, what happened when the energy meter people are connecting to the circuit, that time the current coil carries the load current and pressure coil carries the current, which is proportional to the
supply voltage, that is I to current. The magnetic field, that is nothing but flux phi produced by the series magnet, it is in phase with the line current, and magnetic field produced by flux, that is nothing but flux phi, which is by the shunt magnet, is in quadrature with the applied voltage, that is lagging by the 90 degree. Quadrature is nothing but lagging by the 90 degree with the applied voltage. Now the phase difference existed, no? So that phase difference between the fluxes, these two coils, between these two coils, what it will produce? It will produce the rotating magnetic field, RMF. When this rotating magnetic field is produced, then what happens? Whenever the aluminum disc, it will interact with the disc and interacts with the disc and produces a driving torque. Due to this interactions only, driving torque is produced and thus this starts to rotate. Due to the interaction between the eddy currents and the rotating magnetic field, your disc start to rotate. That is, driving torque is produced. The number of revolutions made by this disc is depends upon the energy passing through the meter, and it is connected to the recording mechanism. Whatever the energy is consumed, it is measured in the kilowatt hour. So this is the working of the energy meter. Next, come to the what are the errors in the energy meter. First one, error due to the creeping. Creeping error is nothing but whenever you are, when the disc will rotate, whenever you people are connecting to the load, that time only the disc start to rotate. But what happens sometimes if you are not connecting to the load also, the your aluminium disc will start to rotate. That is called as the creeping, because if you are not connecting load, the disc should not rotate. That is simply it is a consuming energy. So that is nothing but creeping error. Next come to error due to angle. I told that one important condition is that the voltage in the potential coil or pressure coil current should lag behind the applied voltage by 90 degree. But due to some iron losses and all, it will not exactly 90 degree due to the some iron losses and all. Due to that also some error in the measurement. Next, error due to temperature. See, current is flowing means obviously there will be self-heating of coil and some parts will be there. Due to the temperature changes, obviously resistance will change. So, error in the reading. To avoid that error, we are using the low temperature coefficient material like manganese and all we are using. Next, error due to variation in the supply. Some errors will be occurring due to the variation. Exactly 230 it will be not there due to the some fluctuation in the supply. It may be 228, 220, 225 like that. Supply voltage varies. Due to that also errors in the reading. Error due to friction. Due to some moving parts and all, there will be friction. So, due to that also error in the measurement. Wherever the moving parts is there, then obviously there will be friction. Due to that also the error in the measurement of in the energy meter. Error due to overload. Sometimes what happens, at a time we are applying all the loads, all the whatever the connected loads are there, we are applying. So at that time also there will be some error in the measurement because of some overload. So this is about our about the construction, working and errors in the energy meter. So I hope you all understood about this. Thank you. For more videos, you subscribe my YouTube channel RK Tech.